Hey, welcome to the Chicago Area Homeopathy Study Group. This is Class 3. It's November 10th, 2009. And once again, if any of you need to reach me, you can do so via my website, www.progressivechiropractic.com. So we talked last time about, we were talking towards the end about the placebo response. And I just wanted to make one clarifying point. And I mentioned that sometimes when you get a very dramatic, sudden, quick response to a remedy, you might think that that might be due to a placebo. The difference being in an acute case, which is actually what most of this class is going to be about, acute versus chronic prescribing, when you have an acute case, you do expect a rather quick improvement. So the more severe, the more acute the symptoms are, the quicker the response is going to be with a well-chosen remedy. So for example, if someone is in acute severe pain and you give them the remedy, they may start to feel a decrease in pain within actually seconds or minutes of taking the remedy. So in the case of a fever or body aches with an acute flu or fever syndrome, may actually respond within minutes or certainly within an hour or two. You would expect that. And the higher the potency, the more dramatic dramatic response you would expect from that remedy. So I didn't want to mislead you by suggesting that a very quick and significant improvement from a remedy is always going to be placebo. That's definitely not the case, especially when we're talking about acute conditions. So on the outline, under letter M, like Mary, we've got in the Everybody's Guide to Homeopathic Medicines, page 13, E13, they talk about Herring's Law or rules. I like to call them rules as opposed to a law. Law implies rules are meant to be broken and laws aren't. So these are more rules than laws in terms of how chronic diseases tend to heal, not so much acute, but chronic. When you're treating an acute problem, typically those symptoms that you're treating have just surfaced very recently, so those symptoms tend to be the first to get better. So if you're treating for an acute problem, it's pretty straightforward. The symptoms that you're treating that patient for will tend to resolve the quickest. But generally speaking, there's some rules there of how healing takes place. One is that the healing takes place from deep to superficial. So the deeper symptoms tend to heal first, and then the healing moves superficially. So what may happen is, for example, if you're treating someone with a chronic problem, with, let's say, low back pain and depression and skin problems, eczema, what may happen is that while the back pain starts to get better, you'll see that the skin symptoms tend to get worse. So as the healing takes place, things start moving towards the surface. And we look at those as good signs. Even in the case of like an acute fever or infection, what might happen is you might see the fever getting better, the cough getting better, the headaches getting better, but the patient may start to develop, for example, diarrhea. And that would be actually a good sign that things are moving towards the surface. The body's getting rid of things, or the person may start sweating a lot. You know, again, it's a good sign that we don't want diarrhea to persist or sweating to persist, but it's a sign that things are moving to the surface. The body's getting rid of and healing. The other rule of healing is that it tends to happen in a reverse order chronologically, which is what I was just alluding to. So things that have the most recent symptoms that have appeared tend to go away the first, and the symptoms that have been there the longest tend to take the longest to get better. The other concept, the other rule, is that they tend to be up to down, meaning that just physically in the body, that you know, mental symptoms or symptoms in the head may tend to respond sooner than symptoms literally physically down in the body. And the other thing to keep in mind in an acute disease is that very often when you're treating effectively with an effective remedy, the stages of that disease may be accelerated. So if you start out with someone who has a flu, or let's just take the case of a common cold. For a lot of people, a cold starts out with a sore throat, and then you get nasal congestion, and then there's a cough, and then eventually you're better. So what can happen is you can accelerate those stages. So sore throat goes away immediately, but all of a sudden they start sneezing and being congested much quicker and kind of almost, it may almost seem like sudden or violent. And that's a good sign as long as the earliest symptom is getting better. Now you're thrown into that next stage. Now you might need another remedy for that second phase of that illness. And then, you know, the stuffy nose and congestion seizing may stop, you know, within hours, but then now you're coughing. And so what might normally take 7 days or 10 days or 2 weeks in the case of a cold, the symptoms may seem at first or for a few hours or a day or so, maybe a little more intense, but you're rapidly going through those phases. So you're ultimately, the healing happens quicker than you're typically used to, but it may seem sort of possibly alarming or concerning at first, but it's actually a good sign as long as the person's continuing to move through those stages rapidly. Okay, so the next point in the outline is letter N, also in page 16, under the body's ability to heal. So this is just another comment, we've talked about it before, just the fact that what homeopathy is doing is triggering a healing reaction, or it's facilitating the healing response of the body to recover gently, quickly, safely, naturally, and to be more resilient to that disease and others in the future. So anytime you treat a patient with a given disease effectively with a well-chosen remedy, that person is going to be more resilient or less susceptible to that disease in the future. So in the case of colds, the more times you treat a patient with colds, the less susceptible they'll become to colds. Colds will tend to become less frequent, less intense, less severe, and start to dissipate. Even other unrelated, quote unquote, conditions may start to improve. So just by treating an individual with homeopathy, there tends to be a spillover effect in all areas, regardless of what you're quote-unquote treating them for, because again, you're not treating a patient for a disease, you're treating a patient every time. So every time you give a remedy that the patient gets better because of, you're just boosting the body's ability to heal. You're balancing out the body's overall state of health, or you're tonifying or increasing the vital force of the body. So every time the vital force is improved, better balanced, strengthened, the person is going to be healthier in general, which means they're going to be less susceptible to any disease to some degree. And so the longer they're treated, the better it gets. And you can affect this to some degree by treating for acute conditions. You have a much bigger effect when you're treating someone with a chronic disease, which is, again, kind of outside of the scope of this course, but it's something that you should be aware of. Okay. Any questions on the rules or body's ability to heal so far?